My name is Bryce.
Your 52 seconds was enough.
Oh, we got to finish my 52 seconds because that's how much time my brother has to fool me, and then we got to get back to work because we are constantly and always busy doing stuff. Why are you flipping around? Okay. Just got to make sure everything fits in nicely before I actually secure it in. Everything goes where I want it to go. So cut everything to size. Make sure you're happy with it. And then boom, bam, bam. Boom. Hopefully this fits and I measured correctly. Next step, spray foam and glue gun. First, we're going to glue everything into place. And then we're going to spray foam everything. Turn that around so it works properly. Do this. Something weird happened, all the lights just flickered. I'm kind of just putting the glue on my finger and rubbing it off onto the spots that need it, because it's a lot easier to do it with my finger than it is to get the glue gun in the weird places. Now it's time to shake up the spray foam, get it all ready, and have a little spray bottle in hand, and you'll see what that is for in a moment. A reminder to yourself, Bryce, never buy this brand again. It's terrible. Well, that did not work out exactly as anticipated. I don't know how strong this is going to be and if this is even going to be able to stand up here. Now what I'm doing is just spraying a bit of water onto the parts and then I can mold it. Okay, not yet. So my initial thought was to try and like make a root system from this little branch that I have here, so it branches out and looks all cool. And then what I'll do with that is, as it starts expanding, you spray it with some water and then you can almost mold it as you go. But I don't think I'll be able to do that because structurally I don't know if that will even hold in there. Everything else should be fine and set in place, but that, yay, now everything's dry and it's time to carve out a bit of it. And then I'm going to make this look like a naturalistic rock background while I have help from Benny over here. Benny, come say hi. Come say hi. He's probably had more experience than most people working with all these lovely creatures, hey? The best part is cleaning everything up now. Woo! Now let's try something I've never actually done before. That is now making the rock work background. So I'm using cement and bonding liquid together, gonna paint it on layer by layer, build it up and make it look snazzy, hopefully. We'll see. And I promise you now, this stuff over here is not milk, although it kind of looks like some. So give me some Oreos, please. Ah, goodness gracious. Slowly but surely, something's starting to happen. It's kind of looking like rock, but wow, the work. It's painstaking to get your brush in all these places. Because honestly, that's another fun part of working with these animals. I mean, look at that! It's so cool creating habitats for these guys. Done with the first coat, that is going to be a tree, so that's why it's not painted with the cement. And now I'm doing the first coat on the top page over here. Day two, we gotta get back to it and do about two more layers to the background over here. The reptile studio is a huge, huge mess. The Herb Studio, and I'm wearing the same clothes because, yeah, these are the work clothes. Now to clean up and disinfect the entire floor, just gonna mix a bit of F10 into the mop solution so everything's all nice and sanitary and smells nice too. Almost smells like a vet clinic, so I don't know if that's a nice smell or not, but it is what it is. I really do wish they made longer brooms, because being someone that's tall, you like bending over, breaking your back, pushing the short. So now it's the fun part to put the wrinkles away, well, both of them away for winter so they can get nice and cool so we will be able to breed them this season. Look at that skill, look at that skill. Okay, so now putting the water bowl in her brumation box, right over there like that. Because obviously even over winter they will need a bit of water just in case. They may not drink it, but they might also. And what I'm also going to do is add this boot in there to... Whoa, I nearly just spilled all the water. But give her a nice little place to hide. Say bye to her. You're not going to see her until spring. She's going to be locked away getting nice and chilly, like really cold. Almost down to 9 degrees Celsius in order to breed. It's a very interesting species that needs to get really cold, even though we live here in Africa. So they have relatively hot days and freezing nights. Let's put her away. Love you, girl. Last kiss. Now, why I'm separating them from the rest of the enclosures is because everything else is still heated, and the heat from the enclosures above and below will affect this enclosure's heat, even if I turn it completely off, and it won't get cold enough for them to breed and make babies, because that's what we want. He's nice and big. He's a huge, huge Roncos. Yeah. Look at that. Hey, boy. Don't worry. Generally, wow, that's a nice photo. Cover your eyes with the camera. And we'll put him in this bucket over here, or this tub. There's a nice little place to hide, go down there. Easy as one, two, three, we have the Roncos, and now we're gonna pack them away in a nice cool area of the reptile room, which is essentially that side over there. So the good thing of doing art, like a long time ago, yes, once upon a time I used to do art, that's why this palette is full of, like, you know, pretty colors that I should probably hang up. But that means I have a lot of acrylics left over, so I am going to now paint the background. Hopefully I can do a nice job, and let's get to that. So now the next step, now that this kind of looks like rock, is to make this bad boy look like an actual tree. So this will become the tree stump, and what we're going to do with that is use elastoplaster or liquid rubber, and then stick some like cocoa husk, cocoa fiber, put something that makes it kind of look like a tree stump. And then we're gonna have vines hanging down here. You can barely see the cages behind me, but if I put that light up there, you can see I added some moss and some cocoa fiber in between the rocks in the background. Same thing with this enclosure over here. So I can't wait to show you the final product, because it's starting to look amazing. Ah, guys, there's so much to do. Gonna mix up some substrates now, because I don't want to fill up the substrate here and then plant the plants in here just yet. I'll plant them the morning of the expo, and then probably unplant them, just because it's gonna be very heavy and very hard to move a 1.5 meter enclosure, which is what, 5 foot, I don't know, a really long enclosure with this much substrate in it. That's gonna be super heavy, so I'm gonna mix it in big tubs so we can bring that separately. Okay, so I'm gonna split up the cocoa peat and the cocoa husk half off, then I've got some compost and organic potting soil that I'm gonna mix into the lot with some moss as well. When you see this video, tomorrow is the expo, so come visit. So this mix over here consists of organic potting soil. I put some charcoal, activated charcoal. I put some vermiculite as well as cocoa husk and cocoa peat, and then some moss. I'm supposed to put some organic potting soil, and there's organic compost, and there's a few other components that I still have to add, but so far this is what it's made up of.